Mr. Nygren here. So this is my number 20 fantasy mod for Medieval Total War Kingdoms. So I'm currently doing a preview of the 20 best fantasy mods for Medieval Total War Kingdoms for the PC. So this is Gothic Total War, Chronicles of Myrtana 2.6.1. And it's a cool mod. It has a campaign, and you can also play quick battles and custom battles. You'll go to the faction selection screen of the campaign. See that you have a bunch of factions. You have the Kingdom of Myrtana, the Northern Orcs, Clans of Nordmar, the Mercenaries Onar, and you have the Nomads, the Assassins, Old Camp, Swarm Camp, Kingdom of Aragan, Bandits and Deserters, Southern Orcs, Wanderers Myrtana, County Stewards, Dukedom Torniara, and the Principality Silver Lake. So this modification is based on the role-playing games known as Gothic. I believe it's based on all of them, Gothic 1, Gothic 2, Gothic 3, etc. And I've never played those games, but what I can say is that I own all of them because I bought them in the store, and this mod is based on all of them, I believe, and takes inspiration from all three or four. It has a unique campaign map with a lot of ires, so it's a little bit different because there is a lot of water on the map. I don't know how well the AI will function, but let's jump straight into the campaign and preview some of it. What I can say about the factions is that they have models that are unique, but some of them are borrowed from other places. I believe that there are some Elder Scrolls styled models in this mod, and there might be some models borrowed from Warhammer or Third Age as well, but they are reskinned, and then there are some unique ones too, so it's a mix. The rosters are not very big and such, but I believe the campaign has a lot of polish. It has a lot of text, a lot of events, a lot of cool scripts, etc. The rosters could have had more of a unique style, and instead of borrowing from Warhammer and other stuff, but overall I'd say the style of the models are reminiscent of Elder Scrolls more than anything else. But yeah, we will jump straight into the campaign. See you soon. So we will take a fast look at it. So we have entered the campaign. So one thing that I noticed in this mod is that it doesn't have the multiplayer menu. So you can't go into multiplayer and hot seat, which is a shame, because a lot of people would enjoy playing hot seat in this mod. You know, play as many factions at once, or play with your friends and take turns playing. So one player plays one faction and then click end turn, and then the other player plays the next faction, or you play all yourself. I always enjoyed playing more than one faction in the past. Nowadays I don't really have time. But anyway, it has a good single player campaign, and we are greeted with this screen at the start of the campaign, playing as one of the factions. I took the one that were first in on the list, led by King Robert II, Myrtanian chief. This mod, by the way, is made by Russian modders, but I believe the Italian modder, RAFMC 1989, same guy who led the team behind the Bellomundi 2.0. This guy has also done some music mods in the past for other mods and such, and I believe he did a big portion of the work translating the mod into English. But otherwise, this mod, Gothic Total War, Chronicles of Myrtana, is made by Russian modders, just like Elder Scrolls Total War. And the style of the models in the game are very reminiscent of Elder scrolls. Okay, so it has a lot of unique event pictures, unique scripts and such. Completely unique map. I believe the campaign is also aiming to be more of a role-playing experience, like strategy, but with role-playing elements. So you have like you play like a hero, and you get events and such. It's pretty cool. You can do some missions and things. I haven't played much of this game. I tried it a little bit a few months back. I believe when it released originally a few years back, I also downloaded it and just checked it out. But I did play a little bit in this using the immersion mod or third person mod a few months back, and yeah, it's pretty cool. The battlefields look great, very nice, beautiful terrain, the grass and other stuff. It looks really cool, looks different from other mods. We have unique strat models, both for the generals and for the cities and the walls. We have dungeons that I believe will... If you take a dungeon, you might be rewarded with resources and such. There's a lot of events, as I said. As we can see on the map, it has a lot of ires. Medieval Total War AI usually can't handle ISILs well. So the problem might be that there's a high risk that they won't move troops a lot between different ires, but I don't know. I haven't really played this game much. I wanted to play it, but then I thought that the rosters were either too small or for some factions, or that they looked too much like rosters in Elder Scrolls or Warhammer. There were some unique models. But most of the factions have very small rosters, which is a minus, I guess. But it's still a cool fantasy game. And it's more finished and polished than some of the other fantasy mods out there that I have ranked higher. And the reason I have ranked others higher is because this mod, while having a completely custom campaign, new scripts, new events, dungeons, and role-playing elements and such. The reason it's not ranked as high as the others, and is on the 20th place, but it's still made top 20, so I still picked it over some of the others, because there are more than 20 fantasy mods for Medieval Total War Kingdoms, and this mod ended up on place 20 on my list because I thought it was really cool and had some amazing features and very polished. But as I said, the main setback is that the most of the factions have very small faction rosters, and some of them share units with each other, and only very few factions have a good number of units. So I say this mod could use some work, adding more units to the factions and such. But yeah, I'd say this is the number 20 fantasy mod of Medieval Total War Kingdoms according to me, because it has a lot of stuff that it brings to the table. And the only reason it's not ranked higher is because of the small faction rosters, and because many of the units are borrowed from other fantasy mods. But they are still impressive in this mod with unique skins and such, and I believe there are some units that are unique too. Okay, and seen this exit back to the custom battles. I won't speak too long because we want to preview others and don't want the video to be too long. But these are the factions in custom battle. You have some additional factions. So you have the Kingdom of Myrtana, you have the Northern Orcs, you have the Clans Nordmar, you have the Mercenaries Onar, the Nomads, the Assassins, that's a different faction, the Old Camp, Swamp Camp, the Tribes Goblins, Kingdom of King Margan, Bandits and Deserters, Southern Orcs, Wanderers Myrtana, Countess Duvark, Dukedom of Torneara, Myrtanium Imperium, Principality Silver Lake, Brotherhood Tozo, and we have the Undead. Okay, and if we check the factional rosters, we just want to preview some of the factions here. I've never done a top 20 video before, but the thing is, I tried to do one in the past, but I am very unused to, you know, editing videos in movie editing programs, and you know, adding numbers like 20, 10, it should be easy, but I've never done it before, and I'm also not used to doing videos like this, but I wanted to do a top 10 or top 20 fantasy mods for Medieval 2 for a few years now. I've also wanted to do one for historical mods and one with every type of mod. So a top 20 fantasy mods, a top 20 historical mods, and then a top 20 mods, where I combine historical and fantasy mods, and only the best ones will be ranked in that video. But we start with the fantasy mods, and this is the top 20. This is the number 20. We start with the number 20, and then we move down until we reach number 1. Okay, so Gothic Total War Chronicles of Myrtana 2.6.1. Easily a fantasy mod that you should try out, because it's a really well-made mod. And the only setback is that the rosters are a bit small. So you can see there are still a bunch of unique units in this mod. And the style is very, very reminiscent of the Elder Scrolls Total War style. But I believe the units in this mod are based on older Medieval 2 models. They look a little bit old school in battle, but unique. We have unique siege pictures here. I don't know if they are unique in battle though, but the pictures are pretty cool. The units, they are unique, and yeah, they look like, not like Elder Scrolls here, but some of the factions have like Warhammer and Elder Scrolls models, but others have completely unique models, but they are based on older vanilla models, I believe. That's why they look a little bit old in battle, but they still look cool. So it's still a cool mod, and as we can see, the Kingdom of Myrtana, the main faction, has a huge roster. But you can also see that after the siege engines here, we have all the mercenaries, we have a bunch of different outlaws and pirates and other stuff. They are mercenaries, so they are probably available to everyone in the game. And the real roster for the faction is the units prior to the siege engines. So these units are unique to the faction. It's a human faction. We have the assassins. They also have a unique roster. Really cool roster. And then we see that they also have mercenaries. Mostly the same as the other faction. Probably all of them are the same. But the factional roster is unique, even though much smaller than the Myrtana roster. We have the Northern Orcs. So the Orcs, they look a bit like the Elder Scrolls models here, I think. But they still have unique looks. They aren't exact copies, but probably is using assets from Elder Scrolls to some degree. We have the Old Camp. They didn't have much of an army, 4 units, and then a lot of mercenaries available to the faction. We have the mercenaries owner. They have a unique roster, looking pretty good in my opinion. We have the swamp camp. They also have a unique roster, but looks like more like reskins of the same humans in use by the Myrtana faction. We have the nomads, a lot of cavalry and human troops. But also, I believe many of them are reskins of the other units. We have the tribes of goblins, and this faction I believe had units that looked very much like from other game mods. I mean, for example, these units are skinned Mordor orcs, I'm pretty sure, but here they are goblins, or they are skinned orcs of the Misty Mountain goblins, actually, from Third Age Total War. Then we have this goblin, looked like something from a different mod, but I might be wrong. And we have these units, could be something from the Lizardmen of Warhammer, beginning of the End Times, I don't know. But I know that at least these three are models reskinned from Third Age. And this one could very well be Warhammer or something else. So yeah, the mod has unique skins for every unit, but might be using models from other mods. And lots of reskins of the same units. So the variation is not that great, mostly human factions. Okay, and then there were some others, but we have seen enough of this mod. I rank this mod as the number 20 fantasy mod currently on my list. I went through all of moddb.com, plus I had some additional mods that aren't on moddb that I will also have in my list. Or on my list, actually. So, I'm a Swedish guy, so you have to excuse me if I'm not at my best and I speak English here, but usually I will improve during the video, because usually when I start up a new video, I I am not the best. But anyway, this is the number 20 mod, Gothic Total War Chronicles of Myrtana 2.6.1. I highly recommend trying it out. It has a lot of unique stuff that it brings to the table. The rosters are its only setback, in a sense. They are not varied enough and are heavily using models from other fantasy mods that are reskinned. But they still look unique, and I still think this is a mod worth playing, and I might actually start a campaign in it in the future. I have never played Gothic Total. I never played the Gothic games. I bought them in the store because they were cheap, but never played them. And well, I might start a campaign in this, but I don't know anything about the lore, and I haven't played much of this mod. I tried a campaign and played a few battles, and I can say that the battlefields look great. Can take a fast look to a quick battle. The loading screens are great too, very unique, and it has a intro video when you start a campaign that is very unique as well. Probably taken from the official games or not, I don't know. But it's a video that looks nothing like Total War, more like a role-playing video. Look at this, the battlefields are completely custom and unique. Grass, etc. looks very, very good. I say the battlefields in this mod are very, very impressive. They look very, very unique. It's the models that aren't that great, but still, they have some unique models that look good, like this one, for example, Unar's Chosen Guards. And we have a model that seemed to use heads from Third Age, I'm not sure, but different body. We have this model looking unique. Maybe all of them are unique, but yeah, there are some probably that are based on, I believe, certain Parts of the models might be taken from other mobs, and in the case of the goblins, you saw that they were just reskinned Orcs of the Misty Mountain goblins. But yeah, I still think this mod is worth playing, and the battlefields look really amazing. I mean, I have never seen this grass before in any other mod, and it looked very beautiful. Okay, so start the battle. See that the enemy troops here also have some unique units. Unique cavalry. We can see that the cavalry is unfortunately vanilla medieval too. But the riders, the knights here, the veterans, Myrtanian veterans, they are unique. Maybe the skin for the horse is unique too, but the horse itself is vanilla medieval too. Okay, we have some unique infantry, we have some horse archers, they also look very unique, but we have some marker horses here, borrowed from some other mods, probably Residue Total War or something. Okay, so this mod, very very beautiful battlefields, cool rosters, a unique campaign. The minus is that it doesn't have any multiplayer hot seat. They should add that, in my opinion. Hot seat is one of the modes that people enjoy. Even if they want it to be a different campaign with lots of events and scripts and more of a role-playing event, it would still be cool if you could play more than one faction or play with your friends. So I think they need to add the hot seat option, the multiplayer hot seat campaign. But besides that, I think it's impressive, and unfortunately the multiplayer option is removed from the menu. Okay. Thank you for watching. This is number 20. Now we will move on to number 19 on the list. Bye.